Hello, this is Margaret from Seventh Heaven Tarot. This is 31 Days of Tarot for 2021. And this is my second video for 31 Days of Tarot this year. This video will be about my most favorite oracle decks of 2020. And I'm beginning with the Inspirational Visions oracle by Judy Mastrangelo. And it sits in a beautiful box with a guidebook, but it's a beautiful guidebook, but there's not much information for each card, but it's enough. Maybe some of you will think this is a fluffy deck, but I like it very much. It has beautiful turquoise gilding on the sides, and I will show you some of the cards. This is the back. The Moon Fairy Goddess, Fairy Swan Rides, Knight and the Dragon, Fire Dragon, Create Your Fantasy, Peaceful Garden, Eternal Spirit. I use this fairy tale oracle with my fairy tale tarot deck, and that's Tarot of the Divine, and it's paired very well together. Excalibur, Penguin Riding By, Gingerbread Witch. It has a few darker cards, but not many, and there are unicorns in this deck, a teddy bear picnic, there are cards from the story of Alice in Wonderland, Morning Glory Fairy, Fairy Honeymoon, this is one of the darker cards. There is discord even in fairyland. Jack and the Giant. Hansel and Gretel. Mounting Pegasus. Land of Pegasus. Tulip Fairy. Sleeping Beauty, Welcome to Make Believe, again a unicorn, Dogwood Fairy, this one I like, Bunny Gardener, Pen and Unicorn, and the last one I want to show from this deck, Paradise of Children. Now I'm going to another favorite oracle deck of mine from 2020. It's a little older, this deck. It's the Spirit Animal Wisdom Oracle. I don't think it's from 2020. I think it's a few years older. I use this deck with the White Sage Tarot. This is the back. There's no gilding, but dog. Peacock. There are symbols on the cards for the element. Cat. And there are key phrases. In the Inspirational Visions Oracle, there were also key phrases. There are key phrases and keywords in this deck. Deer. Swan, horse, and it pairs beautifully with White Sage Tarot. Slot. I haven't tried it with one of my other animal decks, but I will in the future. Kangaroo, crane. snake, butterfly, panther, raven, golden unicorn, there's also a unicorn in this deck, fox, and a ladybird. I love it when there's a ladybird in the deck. Wolf, leafcutter, and penguin, phoenix, otter, starfish. This is such a beautiful deck. Giraffe, field mouse, and elephant. I don't know if I said the name of the creator. It's Katie Jane Wright. But I will put the names of the creators and the artist in the description box below. Next one is the Yggdrasil Oracle. And this is a black and white deck. It's from Hauker Haldersson. I don't know if I pronounce it correctly, but I will put the name in the description box. It's a black and white deck, and I'm not usually very fond of black and white decks, but because these are pictures from Norse mythology, I'm liking this very much. This is the back of the cards, and I pair this with my beautiful Norse tarot, and I love that deck, and I love the stories. I love myths and fairy tales. This is Balder, Odin, Frigg, Freya, Tyr, Frey, the brother of Freya, Not, Thor, Heimdall, Mok, Sin, Gandalf. I believe he is a character in Lord of the Rings. Hel from the underworld, the goddess from the underworld. She's the daughter of Loki and a giant. Rida, Eden with the apples of immortality. He is the god of the moon, and Sol is the goddess of the sun in Norse mythology. Hiroki, Sif, Nana, Brok, Skirnir, Kuazir, Ul, Alfrun. I feel like I'm butchering these names, but I'm trying to pronounce them correctly, but forgive me if I'm not doing that well. Hermod and Vari, that's someone with a mask on. There are a lot of cards in this deck. I believe more than 80 cards. I will take a look. 81 cards, and 81 cards and a 215 page guidebook. So you get a lot of good information for your money with this deck. Now I'm going to the only indie oracle deck in my collection. It is the Divas of Creation. I ordered it this on the site of Cilla Conway at the same time as I ordered the Shimmering Fist. I paired this oracle deck with the Lightseer's Tarot. That was very surprising, that combination, that it worked. And I don't think I will pair this with the Shimmering Veil Tarot. I like to pair my oracle decks with tarot decks from different creators. And it reads very intuitively. And there are numbers, small, on the cards, and you can look them up in the guidebook what they mean. This is called Love, if I remember correctly. And I gave the side of the cards different colors. So I made this side yellow because the card is mostly yellow. And the colors looked very good alongside the cards of the Lightseer's Tarot. I also paired the Lightseer's Tarot with Angels and Ancestors Oracle by Kyle Gray. And that was also a beautiful combination. This looks like the devil. It's called the Shadow. And this card for me has tower energy. And this moon energy. And this card has sun energy. Oh, this is also called the sun in the guidebook, I remember. This looks like very fast energy. This looks very chaotic. This is Mercury. All the planets are in this deck. This is the Insect Kingdom. This card, I believe, is male energy. This is Saturnus. Saturnus is related to time, and it refers to being held captive in space and time. This is Jupiter. This is the storm, which is going on for ages. This is a desert. This is, I think, some kind of plant energy. This is autumn. And I don't remember every card in this deck, which name it has and which name it has. I'm going to the last oracle deck, the fifth one. It's in no particular order, so it's not my least favorite from these five. I don't know which is my favorite oracle deck. This is the Mists of Avalon Oracle by Rose Insera, and Nanda Turner. I will read the back of the box. What's it about exactly? It's about King Arthur and the Camelot story, connected to Druidic lore and the magic of Morgan Le Fay. You can pause the video if you want to read it. It's by Rockpool. This is the back of the cards. I think this is my most beautiful Arthurian oracle deck. I have Morgan Le Fay, King Arthur, Taliesin, and the descriptions of the cards in the book are very nice. Igray, Excalibur. This is... oh, I can't read it without my glasses. It's Chalice Hill. Star card vibes I get from this card. This is Caradwen. This has judgment vibes for me. Blow the Wet. This is Galahad. The King of the Fairy Kingdom. Rhiannon. This is Nimue. And of course, Lancelot is also in this deck. Bridget, with her flamey red hair. And of course, the Holy Grail. The, what's this? Lady Shallot. I don't know who that is. I have to read the stories again, I think. Camelot. The Shelley's Well. This is a beautiful fairy. And Merlin, the wizard. The White Spring. Yes, it's called the White Spring. This card is called the Isle of Avalon, and there's mist, so this card goes well with the title of the deck, the Mists of Avalon Oracle. And this card is called the Mist of Avalon. It's on the front of the box. Dragon energy. This is Branwen. The Holy Tree. The Abbey. And Sacred Union. These cards are very beautiful. I combine them with my Robin Wood tarot, and that works very well. Thank you for watching. If you haven't subscribed to my channel already, please do. And I will see you in my next video. Bye!